तो और सब्जेक्ट नेम इज काइनामेटिक्स एंड थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन। लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग दैट प्रीवियसली देयर वेयर टू सब्जेक्ट्स, नेमली थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन वन एंड थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन टू। एंड दिस टू सब्जेक्ट्स हैज कंबाइंड टुगेदर एंड इट हैज मॉडिफाइड एज ए काइनामेटिक्स एंड थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन वन टू। नाउ दैट टू सब्जेक्ट्स और टू पेपर्स आर नॉट देयर। सो प्रीवियसली द काइनामेटिक पार्ट वॉज इंक्लूडेड इन थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन वन एंड वेयर एज रिमेनिंग दैट इज डायनेमिक पार्ट वॉज इंक्लूडेड इन द थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन टू। हाउ यू मे सी बेसिकली इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द टाइटल ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट वन कैन मेक टू द कंक्लूजन दैट दिस इज वॉट रिलेटेड टू द मशीन्स। एंड सेकेंड थिंग वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू ऑब्जर्व इज दैट what we are going to see is the it is one of the core subject of mechanical engineering. So by the name of this subject only we can come to know that this is what we can say is the core of mechanical engineering. And hence we are going to give due attention towards this subject. Before starting, if you have any query, you can directly ask by unmuting yourself. And if you have any question later on also, you can call me on my number. I will provide you my number. Everybody can note it. I'll write here my number. And it's can you see this number? This is my WhatsApp number. You can text on this. You can write me on this. And another number is there. On which you can call me. No doubt that you can call on both the numbers, but WhatsApp is available only on the first number. So related to this subject, if you have any query, if you have any doubt, then you can directly contact me on this number. Or you can write me mail on sysaronk@sue.sweary.ac.in. On this number you can, or on this mail ID you can write me mail if you put any query. Okay. We'll move further. First of all, we are going to see what are the prerequisites of our subject, of our course. Because when we are going to complete this course, then we may be able to do some calculations. We will be able to analyze some part related to the mechanical engineering. We will understand some core definitions, and later on we will move further towards the again core part, that is designing of any components and machineries. Okay, so this is what the basic thing which we are going to learn in the mechanical engineering. So what are the prerequisite subjects, the subjects you which you might have learned already, that are required for this subject, to understand this subject, to understand the concepts which we are going to use in this subject, in this course. So first we can say that it requires basically engineering mathematics, because mathematics is the base of our engineering. More precisely, we can say it as a applied mathematics. So applied mathematics, where number of calculations, series, and
various methodologies are discovered by the great mathematicians that are we are going to implement, and we are going to study the further concepts, and we can create something new. We can give the solution to the society so that mankind can live their life happily on this planet Earth. So once again, I will describe our main, what is aim of our that engineering, basically mechanical engineering. So what we have to do is that we have to analyze the situation, like this pandemic situation, like today what we are suffering, basically our country is suffering, because all over the world the situation is horrible. But as far as our country is considered, we are suffering through a very, very horrible situation. These are nothing but the problems which are around us, and whether we are capable to provide some solution to that problem, that we have to think. And if we are able to provide the solution, let it be. That solution may not be feasible, that may not be economically good, but if you are able to provide that solution, and later on if you think on that, that whether it is feasible, can we do it, or how much money is required for that. But if your solution is capable to withdraw this all situation, and if you are able to provide some better things to the mankind or society, then we can say that engineer has succeeded in his aim. So that is what we can say our basic thing is. I will repeat it once again. आपण इंजिनिअरिंग शिकतोय, इंजिनिअरिंगचा अर्थच आहे की अप्लाइड सायन्स, म्हणजे बेसिकली सायन्सची प्रिन्सिपल वापरून आपण आत्ता समाजात असलेल्या प्रॉब्लेमला उत्तर देणं, सोल्युशन तयार करणं, ते इंजिनिअरचं काम आहे ॲक्च्युली. त्यात मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, सिव्हिल, हे सगळे जे ब्रँचेस आहेत त्याच्यानुसार तेथील लोक त्या क्षेत्रातल्या प्रॉब्लेमची डील करतात. आपलं आहे मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, आपण मेकॅनिकल रिलेटेड जे प्रॉब्लेम आहेत, इट डझंट मीन दॅट यू कॅनॉट एंटर इन सिव्हिल, इट डझंट मीन दॅट यू कॅनॉट एंटर इन कम्प्युटर. हे सगळे जे आहेत ते एकमेकाशी को रिलेटेड, एकमेकाशी संबंधितच आहेत. थिअरी ऑफ मशीन ज्यावेळेला आपण शिकतो, और कायनामॅटिक्स अँड थिअरी ऑफ मशीन हा ज्यावेळेला कोर्स आपण शिकतो, त्यावेळेला सिव्हिलमध्ये जर काही प्रॉब्लेम अराईज झाले आणि त्याचं सोल्युशन जर तुमच्याकडून देता आलं, तर दॅट इज ऑल्सो बेटर. आणि अशा आपल्या अवतीभवती जे प्रॉब्लेम येत आहेत, त्या प्रॉब्लेमला आपण सोल्युशन देणं, हे इंजिनिअरिंगचं बेसिक काम आहे, नो डाऊट. आता आपण शिकतोय, चांगली मार्क मिळवतोय, त्याच्यानंतर आपलं पुढचं एम आहे की आपल्याला चांगली नोकरी मिळवणं. चांगली नोकरी मिळाल्यानंतर त्याच्या पुढचं आपलं एम बऱ्याच जणांचे वेगवेगळे, आणि त्याच्यानंतर पुन्हा अजून बरेच वेगवेगळे एम असणार आहेत. पण इंजिनिअरिंगचं मेन मोटिवेशन हे आहे की आपण आत्ता ज्या सभोवतालच्या सिच्युएशन्स आहेत, ज्याच्यामध्ये प्रॉब्लेम आहेत, ते शोधून काढणं आणि त्याला सोल्युशन प्रोव्हाइड करणं. आता हे काय खूप म्हणजे सोपं नाही आहे. बेसिकली प्रॉब्लेम शोधणं हा खूप मोठा टास्क आहे. इट रिक्वायर्स व्हेरी हाय क्वालिटी ऑफ इमॅजिनेशन, इट रिक्वायर्स व्हेरी हाय क्वालिटी ऑफ क्रिएटिव्हिटी. आणि त्या क्रिएटिव्हिटीनं आपण अवतीभोवती असलेले प्रॉब्लेम आपण फाइंड आउट करतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, मी कॉलेजला जात असताना सायकलवरून जात होतो. सायकलवरून जाणं हा माझा प्रॉब्लेम आहे हा मला समजायला 10 वर्ष लागतील, कारण माझ्याकडे गाडी नाही आहे, टू व्हीलर नाही आहे. मग मी टू व्हीलर नसणं हा माझा प्रॉब्लेम झाला, तर तो समजून घ्यायला, नाहीतर मी आय एम व्हेरी हॅप्पी विथ माय बायसिकल. इफ आय थिंक इन दॅट वे, देन वी कॅनॉट गेट द बेटर सोल्युशन. बऱ्याचदा आपण असं म्हणतो की आपल्याकडे जे आहे त्याच्यात आपण समाधानी राहिले पाहिजे, तसं असतं तर अजून पण आपण गुहेतच राहिलो असतो, दगडानं आणि लाकडी काठ्या वगैरे असतात त्यांना आपण शिकार करत असतो, जर आपण त्यात समाधानी असतो तर. हे सगळे इनोव्हेशन्स जे समाधानी लोक नाहीत, इवन COVID-19 पण इनोव्हेशन त्याच लोकांच्यामुळे झालं जे लोक समाधानी नाही आहेत. ओके, बट आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द पॉझिटिव्ह साईड ऑफ दिस इनोव्हेशन, नॉट अ निगेटिव्ह साईड. इवन ॲटॉमिक बॉम्ब हॅज ऑल्सो डिस्कवर्ड फॉर नॉट बिईंग सॅटिस्फाईड. because of the present situation, whatever may be at that time. Even aeroplanes upon innovation, त्याच्यामुळे झाले की ज्यावेळेला राईट बंदून वाटलं, दे वेर नॉट हॅपी अबाउट द सिच्युएशन. पतंग उडवत होते ते, पण त्याच्यातनं ते त्यांना सुख मिळत नव्हतं. सो दे फाइंड द एरोप्लेन. किंवा जेम्स वॅट, हु हॅज डिस्कवर्ड द इंजिन, स्टीम इंजिन, ॲक्च्युली ही हॅज नॉट डिस्कवर्ड, ही हॅज डेव्हलप्ड दॅट स्टीम इंजिन. समबडी एल्स हॅज डिस्कवर्ड इट ॲक्च्युली, अँड ही हॅज जस्ट डेव्हलप्ड इट. पण त्या जेम्स वॅट जर त्या सिच्युएशनमध्ये नव्हता, ठीक आहे म्हटलं असता की माणसानी वल्लवायच्या बोट आहेत, चालत जात होती लोक एक तिकडं, किंवा घोड्याचा किंवा बैलाचा वापर करत, हत्तीचा वापर करत होते, त्यावेळेला जर त्याने विचार केला असता की कशाला स्टीम पाहिजे, वी आर हॅपी विथ द एलिफंट्स, काऊज अँड डॉग्स अँड ऑल दॅट. सो वेन ही बिकम्स अनहॅपी विथ दॅट, ही फाईंड आउट द सोल्युशन, ही क्रिएट दॅट प्रॉब्लम. त्यामुळे आपल्याला आपला प्रॉब्लेम आपण डिफाईन केला पाहिजे, नंतर त्याला मग हजारो जण सोल्युशन देऊ शकतील, नो डाऊट. त्याच्यासाठी तुम्हाला आफ्टर कम्प्लिशन ऑफ युअर ग्रॅज्युएशन यू कॅन अप्लाय फॉर वन एक्झाम विच इज कंडक्टेड बाय आय आय टीज, अँड दॅट एक्झाम नेम इज CEED, कॉमन एंट्रन्स एक्झाम फॉर डिझाईन. नाऊ डेज यू कॅन, इट इज इक्वेलंट टू द गेट. And after that, you will get admission to the MDES course in all IITs and ISC Bangalore, where you can have 2 years of your master's degree in designing. And that requires very high creativity. If you want to pass that exam, if you want to have the score of in that exam, then your creativity plays very important role in that. Later on, when you come to the college and when we'll have the interaction, I will explain everything about this CEED examination. I have told you about this because this is what we expect. Now, coming to our point, that what the subject, our course requires, that prerequisites, subjects, that is mathematics. You should have the good background of mathematics. Then you should have good background of physics also, engineering physics. These two subjects already you have learned in your first year of our entire program. Then what we required is the knowledge of material, okay? That is mechanics of material, which that subject already which you have learned, okay? That previously it was called as a SOM, strength of material. Then engineering mechanics, that is applied mechanics or engineering mechanics, the subject which already you have learned. Then good knowledge of graphics also required in this subject. So all these subjects and much more we required. But these are the some subjects which you have learned already and from which you can just have the better knowledge and we can further go to this subject. Well, let me ask one question. Can you see the screen properly? Is it visible and is it readable?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you read on that screen? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yeah. Can you just read? That means I am not asking you to read, but can you read it, what we have written on the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, no problem. But I was worried about that, whether you are able to read it or not. That's why I asked you. Okay, no problem. So further moving, we'll see the syllabus, university syllabus of our course. How university has defined this course to the SYBTEC in the second semester of SYBTEC. Name has given as a kinematics and theory of machines. We do have 3 hours per week in which we have to complete this course. And practical will have of 2 hours per week. A marking structure of this course is that we have to appear for the 70 marks theory examination, which will be conducted by the university. As we know that we have to go for the ISCs, 1, 2 and 3 ISCs. Out of that, we are going to have the average of base 2, and that will provide to the university. Then internal continuous assessment, that is term or, is of 25 marks. And we'll have external oral also on this entire course. And that will be of 25 marks. At the end of semester, when we are appearing for the examination, we will have the oral, and at that time you have to perform well. Okay. Then university has defined some goals, outcomes, or we can say it as a course outcomes, COs, for this unit or for this course. And that are, first is that select proper type of mechanism for different applications. Then determine velocity and acceleration of different components in that mechanism. Then select proper type of cam and follower for any application and draw the cam profile for the required application. Then select proper type of brakes for various applications. Then select gear and design gear trains for the application, any application. Then analyze the effect of gyroscopic couple on any vehicle like ship, aeroplane, two-wheeler or four-wheeler. Then design governor for different use, governors we are going to learn in this course. And last one is do balancing of rotary and reciprocating masses. These are the COs which are defined by the university for this course. If you go through the syllabus, then there are 8 units. This entire course is divided in 8 units, which we are going to cover throughout the semester. The how many time which is available for us, let us see. Out of that, this first unit is simple mechanism. I have described here the syllabus which has given by the university. Second unit, just I will go by unit, okay. First unit is of simple mechanism. Second unit is of velocity and acceleration in that mechanism. Third unit is of cam. Fourth unit is of brakes. In this simple mechanism, we are going to see the introductory part of our course. Second unit, we are going in details and we are moving towards the dynamic part. That is, we are going to find the velocity and acceleration, because velocity is nothing but moving part. So we are moving towards the dynamic part of this course. Third is CAM. We are going to see the different types, then applications, and how to design a profile. That we are going to learn in this unit. Next is brakes. So brake is the mechanical component which is used from the ancient age when the wheel has been discovered. You know that revolution has taken place when wheel has discovered. So when that wheel has discovered, after that the brakes are discovered, because if you are going to give motion, we should control that motion, and the controlling of that rotary or moving, that linear motion, is done by means of the brakes. And hence we are going to learn the brakes in that unit. And unit, that is first section where we have covered 4 units. Then unit number 5, 6, 7 and 8 are covered in the second section, in which gear and gear trains are the we are going to learn what are the gear. That is, in that we are going to see gear geometry, nomenclature and various applications, types of that gear. And next, gear trains, in which we are going to see how the trains, that train is nothing but connected gears. Gears are connected to each other. That's why it is called as train, just like we do know the railway train, that bogies are connected with each other. And that's why it is called as train. Then gyroscope. Now, gyroscope is one of the concept, and based on that concept, we are going to see what are the applications of that gyroscope, where it get affects, when, what is the situation where the gyroscopic couple is generated, emerged. Okay, so we are going to see that concept and upwards its applications. Then we are going to see governors. Nowadays, you may say that governors are eliminated in actual practice, but it is not the case. In mechanical engineering, till we do have these engines and turbines, we need these governors. We need the controlling units. So you can say the governors are the required part. Now, one more thing is that if you are thinking that everything will be get replaced by the electrical motor, because nowadays in automobile sector, the revolution is taking place that electric cars are coming in market. But it is a very, very, we can say, short application of the engines. Because we cannot replace engines which are used for the commercial purpose, like aeroplanes, like ships, like trains, where the maximum utilization of engine is there. In case of two-wheelers and four-wheelers, where we are going to say automobile sector, no doubt that automobile sector is playing a very, very important role in mechanical engineering and globally also. And it is get replaced by means of the electrical motors. But it is a 20% application of entire application of that engine. Remaining 80% is the field where the engines cannot be replaced by the motor. Because you know that, you might have seen that movie where the engine is shown. Okay, I'll explain it later on. Very, very big engines are required for the propagation of shafts, ships. And most of the transportation from one country to another country, whereas in within the country also is done by means of ships, because it is the cheapest means of transportation. And one more thing, now the luxury of the aeroplane we can have, and that also requires very huge amount of energy and power. So that cannot be replaced by means of electrical motors. It requires maybe 100 and 200 years to replace the engines which are used for aeroplane and ship by means of electrical motors, because the storage of that electricity is very, very important and vital, and that cannot be done nowadays. Okay, I'm saying it doesn't mean that it will not happen. It will happen, but it will take time, which we may not be able to see, including you and me too. So this governors we are going to study. And last unit is of balancing, where we are going to learn some principles of balancing, and we are going to learn how to balance the unbalanced mass. In some applications, because of the structure, we can say, because of the mechanism which we are going to use, automatically unbalance creates, and that unbalance is going to lead further unwanted things, and that we are going to learn in this unit number 8. Now here I am going to stop discussion of this what we can say syllabus. Later on we'll go to the next part of the syllabus, but in details when we are going to see that unit, that we'll see. As I already have told you that ISC we have to conduct, based on which we will have the minimum 2 tests here university has mentioned, but we are going to conduct 3 tests, okay, including midterm also as a written test, and based on that we are going to examine the students, we are going to assess the students. The next part is of practical type, that is continuous assessment, that is term 4, where at least 1 to 4, these are the compulsory type of experiments, and any 4 of the remaining, there are total 9, out of that 1, 2, 3, 4 are compulsory, and from 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 any 4 can be conducted. Okay, so let's see how the time is permitting us for conducting these practicals, or whether it is possible to conduct these practicals based on what we can say, this scheme where we'll provide a video conferencing, and we'll let to know how the experiments are conducted and how we can do the practicals on that. Okay, next part is of the books which we can refer. You can find these books on Google also. If you find any soft copy of this, you can read it, or I will provide you link, the soft copies which are available with me. I will provide you that links, and you can download it on your mobile or laptop or desktop, and you can read it. So first book is Balani PL, Theory of Machines, Khanna publication. Kurmi RS and Gupta JK, Theory of Machine by S. Chand publication. And R.K. Bansal, Theory of Machines, Lakshmi publications. And V.P. Singh, Theory of Machine by Dhanpat Rai and Son publication. These are the textbooks. These textbooks are nothing but the based on which we have designed that syllabus. त्या टेक्स्टबुकचा वापर करून आम्ही तो सिलेबस डिझाईन केलाय. आम्ही पॉईंट घेतलेत त्या सिलेबसमधले. ओके, ह्या टेक्स्टबुकना लिहिण्यासाठी हे रेफरन्स बुक वापरले गेले. हे रेफरन्स बुक, यू कॅन ऑल्सो रेफर दिस रेफरन्स बुक. ओके, अँड दॅट आर रतन एस एस. सो आय थिंक दिस इज द बेस्ट बुक फॉर द अंडरस्टँडिंग अँड लर्निंग आउट ऑफ ऑल दिस बुक्स. Okay, no doubt this all books are important, these are good, but this Ratan, I think it's good, best book. Okay, it is Tata McGraw Hill publication, and Sigley Joseph, that is Sigley J, Theory of Machines and Mechanisms by McGraw Hill publications, student edition. Then Thomas Bevan, this is Theory of Machine by CBS publication, New Delhi. And Governor, and there is Grover, actually Grover, Mechanical Vibration, name of book is Mechanical Vibration, and publisher is Tata McGraw Hill. So this Grover book is also one of the good or so better book in the field of mechanical engineering, understanding the basic concepts of vibration. So this is about the syllabus. Let me know that do you have any doubt up till now. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, no problem. So next we'll move further and we'll see what are the COs of this course, which we have decided, our institute has decided basically. So the first CO, we have given nomenclature to the CO as a ME224. It means that our subject name is 224. This is reference code. And Bloom's level we have defined for that all COs. So first CO is distinguished between different mechanisms and draw velocity and acceleration diagram for different mechanisms. Our outcome is that we will be able to distinguish between different mechanisms, and we'll be able to find out velocity and acceleration for that mechanism. One may ask question that why it is required to find the velocity, and next is our acceleration, because derivative of displacement we have to take, and later on again derivative we have to take for the calculation of acceleration. What all these things are required. So let me explain you here only that what we require is that after all the force which is required to propagate, which is required to move, which is required to do any task. And one cannot find force unless and until he cannot find the acceleration. Because Newton has explained force is nothing but mass into acceleration. So this acceleration is required. When it is multiplied with the mass which you want to move, then we can calculate the force which is required to move that. And this our basically mechanical engineering is the toughest branch of engineering. Why? Because it is dealing with the dynamic parts. So it is very difficult to understand what the kinematic part or static part. You might have studied that how to take the movement, how to draw the SFD and BMD diagram, right? So this SFD BMD is dealing with the static forces. But if the force is applied and if the motion is created, it becomes very difficult to imagine it and find out and explain it. So that comes into dynamic part, and that's why it is the best part. Okay, so we'll be able to find out that acceleration. Once you find the acceleration, you can find the force. That's why acceleration is required. Then second is that predict the cam profile required for the different motions of followers, that is how the follower is going to move, based on which we can predict the profile of that cam in different application using graphical method. There are number of applications of cam and followers nowadays also from the ancient age, and today also we are utilizing the cams and followers for various applications, and we will be able to design that cam and followers based on this unit. Okay, this will be outcome. And the first unit is required understanding and analyzing. We are going to analyze velocity and acceleration. That's why analyzing is there. Then second is applying. We are going to apply whatever the knowledge which is available with us, the principles, and that's why it is BL level applying. Then examining different parameters of the brakes, brake dynamics. The parameters, that is physical parameters that we are going to discover, find out. And it is also application of the basic laws of science. Then identify and evaluate gear trains. It is analyzing, because we are analyzing that gear trains and its motion. Okay, motion means RPM and all that. So that is analyzing. That's why it is BL level is analyzing. Then illustrate use of controlling device such as governor and gyroscope in various applications. So this unit number 6 and 7 are combined here, and one CO has been made, outcome has been done. It is basically governor is controlling device and gyroscopic couple is also controlling device. That phenomenon is, and one second is mechanism or machine. The two are controlling devices of our moving bodies. And that's why we are going to find out the principle of controlling that motion. Then last outcome is perform balancing of rotary and reciprocating masses. This is the outcome based on the last unit. And these are the 6 COs, force outcomes, which we are tried to inculcate in our personality or thinking when we are going to learn this course. Okay, any doubt? If not, we'll move further. What title suggests us of this course? Kinematics means the branch of mechanics concerned with the motion of object without referring the force. That is called as kinematic, the first word which is there in our course. The theory, you know that theory is nothing but the basic thing, basic part. If you refer it for the mathematics, then it is a collection of properties to illustrate the principle of subject that we are going to say as a mathematical meaning of theory, or a set of principles on which the practice of any activity is based that you are going to call as a theory. So these both meanings we are going to use, and we are going to see the principles as well as the mathematical principles for the operating any machinery. So the theory machine is well defined by great Phunsuk Wangdu. You all of might have seen Three Idiots movie, in which he has explained what the machine is. So very simple definition of machine, which the device which reduces the human efforts, that you are going to call as a machine. And these human efforts are reduced so that human can think better, and we can achieve the better things for all the man's or this live things which are surviving on this earth. But I don't know whether it is fulfilled or not. Let me tell you one story here, and it will take hardly 3 to 4 minutes. And I'll shift to the Marathi to tell the story. It is possible to have the story in English also, but I'll shift to Marathi. एक छोटं खेडेगाव असतं. त्या खेडेगावात 100 लोक राहत असतात. आणि त्या 100 लोकांना त्यांची दिवसाची दिनचर्या करायला 24 तास जात असतात. आउट ऑफ दॅट यू कॅन से 8 तास प्रत्येक जण झोपत होता, आणि राहिलेले 16 तास त्यांच्या दैनंदिन कामासाठी लागत होते. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, पाणी आणायला 2 तास लागत होते, जंगलात जाऊन फळं गोळा करायला 4 तास लागत होते, त्या फळाबरोबर वीट किंवा ज्वारी वगैरे गोळा करून ते आणत होते, घरात दळायला 1 तास लागत होता, हे सगळं प्रिपरेशन करायला त्यांना 2 तास लागत होते. अशा पद्धतीने त्यांचे 24 तास संपायचे. 24 तासापेक्षा जास्त वेळ कुणालाच नसतो, कारण पृथ्वी तेवढ्या वेगानं फिरत नाही किंवा तेवढ्या कमी वेगानं फिरत नाही. पृथ्वीचा वेग आपण कंट्रोल करू शकत नाही, त्यामुळे 24 तास आहेत आपल्याकडे. तर त्या 100 गावातला एक जण तुमच्यासारखा हुशार माणूस होता. त्याने विचार केला की मी पाणी आणायला 2 तास लागतात मला, 1 तास चालत जायचं, 1 तास परत यायचं. रिझर्वायर ऑफ वॉटर त्यानं बघितलं, आणि येता येता त्यानं विचार केला ह्या चालण्याच्या प्रोसेसमध्ये की रिझर्वायर जो आहे पाण्याचा तो हायर अल्टिट्यूडला आहे, आणि आपलं जे खेडेगाव आहे ते लोअर अल्टिट्यूडला आहे. त्यानं काय केलं की त्याचे इतर टाईममध्ये करटल केलं, म्हणजे त्याला लागणारा मासेमारीसाठी समजा त्याला मासे खायची इच्छा असताना 1 तास वेळ लागत असेल तर त्याने ती इच्छा कॅन्सल केली. नंतर फळं आणायला जात होता जंगलात, ती इच्छा त्यानं कॅन्सल केली, घरात असलेल्या भाकरीवरच त्यानं निभवलं. त्याच्यामुळे त्याचे 2 तास वाचले, 3 तास वाचले. हे त्यानं काय केलं की त्या पाण्यापासून ते त्याच्या घरापर्यंत एक पाट खणला त्या 2-3 तासाच्या युटिलायझेशनमध्ये. ओके, वेअर वी कॅन से ही हॅज थिंक इन इनोव्हेटिव्ह मॅनर, अँड ही हॅड फाइंड आउट द प्रॉब्लेम. त्यानं प्रॉब्लेम फाइंड केला की पाणी आणायला 2 तास लागतात, चालत जावं लागतं तेवढं, आणि त्याच्यावरचं त्यानं सोल्युशन पण काढलं. त्यानं इनोव्हेटिव्ह थिंकिंग, त्यानं आधी हा विचार केला की हायर अल्टिट्यूड लोअर अल्टिट्यूड, पाणी हे नेहमी वरून खाली किंवा हायर अल्टिट्यूड करून लोअर अल्टिट्यूडकडे येतं. सायन्सचं प्रिन्सिपल बघितलं त्यानं, निसर्गाचं प्रिन्सिपल बघितलं, हे त्यानं कधी पाऊस चालू असताना किंवा पावसाळ्यात त्याला ऑब्झर्व झालं असेल, इतर कोणाला ऑब्झर्व झालं नसेल. ते जसं की न्यूटनलाच फक्त ॲपल खाली येताना दिसलं, बाकी सगळ्यांनाच दिसत होतं. आपल्यासारखं असतं तर म्हणलं असतं की ते खा, बाकीचा विचार करू नको, राईट? पण त्यानं बाकीचा विचार केला, अँड हिअर वी आर टुगेदर नाव, वी आर लर्निंग दिस हिज प्रिन्सिपल, अँड बेस्ड ऑन हिज प्रिन्सिपल दिस सब्जेक्ट इज बेस्ड, दॅट इज कायनामॅटिक्स अँड थिअरी ऑफ मशीन. सो ही हॅज इनोव्हेटेड मच मोर थिंग्स. तसं त्या माणसाने विचार केला, आणि ते पाणी त्याच्या घराजवळ आलं, आणि ते घराजवळ आल्यानंतर त्यानं सगळ्यांना, राहिलेल्या 99 लोकांना एकत्र बोलवलं, आणि त्यानं सांगितलं की तुम्ही जे 2 तास घालवता पाणी आणायला, त्या 2 तासाच्या ऐवजी तुम्हाला 5 मिनिटात, माझ्या घरापासून तुमच्या घराचं अंतर 5 मिनिटं आहे, त्या 5 मिनिटात तुम्हाला पाणी मिळणार आहे. इट मीन्स दॅट तुमच्याकडं 1 तास 55 मिनिटं शिल्लक राहणार आहे. तर तुम्ही काय करा की त्यातली फक्त 55 मिनिटं मला द्या, 1 तास तुमच्यासाठी वापरा. सगळे खुश झाले. इट्स बेटर डील. 2 तासाच्या ऐवजी 5 मिनिटात कष्ट पण वाचत होतं. अकॉर्डिंग टू फुनसुक वागडो डेफिनेशन पण बरोबर होती, विच रिड्युसेस द ह्युमन एफर्ट्स, एफर्ट्स कमी होत होते. सगळ्यांनी त्याला अग्री केलं आणि त्याच्यासाठी 55 मिनिटं प्रत्येकाने दिले. 99 × 55 एवढे मिनिट्स ही गॉट. किती मिनिट होत आहेत ते मी कॅल्क्युलेट करतो फॉर सिम्प्लिसिटी. 99 × 55 ते येत आहेत 5445 मिनिट्स डिवाइड बाय 60, नियर अबाउट 90.75 आवर्स पर डे. सो प्रिव्हियसली आय हॅव टोल्ड यू दॅट कुणाचाही दिवस 24 तासापेक्षा मोठा नाही आहे, पण त्या माणसाचा दिवस झाला 90 तास 90.75 आवर्स. त्याच्याकडं एका दिवसासाठी तेवढे आवर्स अवेलेबल झाले. मग त्याला जे काही त्याच्या स्वतःच्या कामासाठी लागणारे 5-6 तास होते ती कामं तो दुसऱ्याकडून करून घ्यायला लागला. राहिलेली जी लोकं होती त्यांना त्यानं दुसरी कामं लावली. फॉर एक्झाम्पल त्यानं त्यातले 20 तास तो पाठ अजून मोठा करायला वापरले. राहिलेले 20 तास त्यानं जंगलात जाऊन वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारची लाकडं तोडायला लावले. राहिलेले अजून त्यातनं 10 तास शिल्लक त्या लोकांना त्यानं वेगवेगळे अवजार बनवायला लावले. ओके, आणि तसे त्यानं 90 आवर्स युटिलाइज केले. त्यानंतर पुढे त्यानं काय केलं की दुसरं एक त्याला ऑब्झर्व, त्यानं स्वतःचा वेळ फक्त ऑब्झर्वेशनमध्ये घालवला. मग त्याला एक दुसरा ऑब्झर्व झाला की एक मोठा दगड त्या पाटात पडला होता आणि तो घरंगळत पाण्याच्या फोर्समुळं त्याच्या घरापर्यंत आला. सो ही डिस्कवर्स दॅट त्या पाण्याला, त्या पाण्यामध्ये फोर्स आहे, एनर्जी आहे, सो विच वी कॅन युटिलाइज. त्यानं त्या एनर्जीचं युटिलायझेशन करून एक स्थिर चाक आणि एक फिरणारा दगडी चाक बनवलं, ज्याच्यामध्ये जे वीट किंवा ज्वारी होती दळली जाईल गेली. मग त्यानं परत सगळ्यांना बोलवलं, त्यानं सांगितलं की 1 तास तुम्ही दळायसाठी देताय घरात, माझ्याकडे या 5 मिनिटात पीठ घेऊन जावं. अगेन ही गॉट मोर आवर्स अँड लाईक वाईज द प्रोग्रेशन टेक प्लेस. त्याच्यातल्या गोष्टीचा पार्ट सोडून द्या, जे आपल्याला अंडरस्टँड करायचा तो पार्ट घ्या. गोष्ट संपल्या इथंच, त्याच्या पुढे पण तुम्ही वाढवू शकता ती गोष्ट, पण इथं गोष्ट संपली. त्याच्यात तुम्ही हे अंडरस्टँड करू शकता की हाऊ ही सायन्स गेट डेव्हलप, हाऊ वी आर गेटिंग मोर अँड मोर टाईम अँड हु इज गेटिंग दॅट मोर टाईम. द पर्सन हु इज क्रिएटिव्ह, इनोव्हेटिव्ह, हु कॅन फाईंड प्रॉब्लेम फर्स्ट and we can give the solution for that that person. Okay, like we can take example of Reliance, can take example of Tata, we can take example of General Motors. Okay, ya saglyanchi example same ya story var based right, jani innovative vichar kela ani jana tya velecha upyog kela he got more hours. As Tata aplya peksha jast srimant kasha nahi, paishana nahi hai. बट टाटाचा जो एक दिवस आहे इट मे बी ऑफ 1000 आवर्स किंवा अनिल अंबानीचा एक दिवस हा 1 लाख आवर्स असू शकतो. 1 लाख आवर्स म्हणजे त्यानं प्रत्येक आवर मध्ये 1-1 रुपया कमवला, तर ही इज गेटिंग 1 लाख रुपीज पर डे. अँड ॲज वी आर गेटिंग 8 रुपीज पर आवर, ऑर वी मीन्स आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द सिम्पल $8 पर आवर, आपल्याला तेवढा पगार मिळतो. यू कॅन मल्टिप्लाय युअर टाईम बाय मीन्स ऑफ ॲडिंग द पीपल अराउंड यू अँड इट विल गेट दॅट युअर आवर ऑर युअर डे विल बिकम ऑफ दॅट मच आवर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हॉट वी कॅन से वन प्रिन्सिपल अँड बेस्ड ऑन विच इनोव्हेशन टेकन प्लेस. सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर दिस वी हॅव एक्सप्लेन द टायटल. Now this is what I have explained you the central idea of this course. That what we are going to learn here is the kinematic, that is nothing but the all motions which are not conserving force, and later on we are going to consider the force and mass, and we are going to find out what is the reverse or dynamic part of that. That we are going to learn in this unit. This is what the central idea of this course. Then importance of this course in program. Why? Because it has been added in the syllabus of mechanical engineering. Because unless and until you are not able to find out the basic principles of kinematics, that is all things which are related to the motion, you cannot go for the designing of any new machinery, or you will not able to understand the machineries which are in use. For example, आज बऱ्याच जणांच्या टू व्हीलर आहेत, पण ज्यावेळेला तुम्ही टू व्हीलर पहिल्यांदा चालवायला घेतली होती त्यावेळेला किती जणांना रिझर्व कसं असतं ते माहीत होतं. पेट्रोल जर आपण नॉब खाली केला तर तो ऑन वर असतो, आणि नॉब जर वरती केला, आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द ऑल मोपेड्स, नॉट ऑफ द स्कूटर टाईप ऑफ व्हॉट वी कॅन से टू व्हीलर्स, तिथे त्यांना ते ऑन आणि ऑफचं काही नाहीच आहे, जसं की ॲक्टिवा वगैरे ह्यासाठी. पण आपण साध्या स्प्लेंडर, पल्सर वगैरे ह्या गाड्या घेतल्या तर त्या पेट्रोलचा नॉब खाली केला तर तो ऑनवर असतो, आणि वरती केला तर तो रिझर्व्हवर असतो. पण आपण ज्यावेळेला पहिल्यांदा टू व्हीलर शिकलो त्यावेळेला आपल्याला काय माहित होतं, किती जणांना माहित होतं की ऑन पेट्रोल संपतं तिथं आणि रिझर्व कोट कॅटेगरी किंवा रिझर्व कोटा चालू होतो, ती नॉब वरती करायला लागतो. हे माहिती असणं, दॅट व्हॉट वी कॅन से वी हॅव लर्न इट. ज्याला कोणाला ज्यानं अगोदर ऑब्झर्व केलं होतं, तर ज्यावेळेला टू व्हीलर येत नसताना पण, सो ही इज गुड ऑब्झर्वर. आणि ज्याला माहीत नव्हतं तो किका मारत बसतो, आणि थोड्या वेळानंतर कोणतरी येतं त्याला सांगतो की पेट्रोलचं नॉब वरती कर, इट मे बी रिझर्व्हवर असेल. ओके, सो दॅट इज व्हॉट वेअर वी हॅव फेस द प्रॉब्लेम अँड वी हॅव गॉट द सोल्युशन. सो लाईक वाईज वाय वी रिक्वायर्ड दिस कोर्स, सो टू हॅव नॉलेज ऑफ एनी मशनरी, म्हणजे एखादी आत्ता एक्झिस्टिंग मधली मशनरी आहे त्याचं पण आपल्याला अंडरस्टँडिंग व्हायला ते प्रिन्सिपल उपयोगी पडतात, जे प्रिन्सिपल आपण ह्या सब्जेक्टमध्ये शिकणार. ओके, सो टू हॅव द व्हेरियस युनिट्स ऑलरेडी विच वी हॅव डिस्कस, ऑल दिस आर मर्ज हिअर, अँड दिस इज वाय द कोर्स इज इंट्रोड्यूस इन युअर सिलेबस. देन वी आर गुड टू स्टार्ट दिस युनिट नंबर 1. The name of this unit is simple mechanism. Now we will see in details. Now the unit contents are, first is kinematic link, then kinematic pairs, then classification, then kinematic chain, degrees of freedom, types of constrained motions, then Kujawiak's and Gugler's criteria for the planar mechanism, the structure, mechanism, machine. We are going to see the difference between these three. Then Grashof's law for the four bar mechanism. Then we are going to see the inversion of various mechanisms and inversions of four bar chain. Then single slider crank mechanism and double slider crank mechanism and inversions of that. It's all things which we are going to learn in this unit. Now for this unit, you can refer books like Balani, Kurmi, Bansal and Ratan. No doubt that all the books which we have seen in the syllabus part, that all books are good, but this four books are giving better idea of this unit which we are going to learn. Okay, now assignment part, I will provide you assignment booklet and you have to solve as per the decision which we are going to take afterwards in departmental meeting, how to complete this part task, that is assignment task, whether we have to give any questionnaires or you have to write or online I have to conduct the test, and based on which we'll provide you the marks, because it is one of the tool by means of which I can examine you, I can find out what is the level of grasping and what knowledge you have grasped from this course, so that I can analyze you and I can give mark. Okay, next part is about the title of unit. Simple means easy, plain, basic. Mechanism is the mechanical device which is getting power and having some output as a required output. Okay, that we are going to see the mechanism. And This is what the simple definition of our unit title. Then central idea, we are going to learn all the basic things related to the mechanism, then required part of that mechanism, then difference between mechanism, machine, and structure. Okay, this is what we are going to learn in this unit. This is what the basic things, that's why it is introduced in your syllabus, based on which we are going to see the further part of this course. Now this unit will provide us the degrees of freedom, what is the degrees of freedom and how we can find out the degrees of freedom. Then describe kinematic pair and determine the motion. What is the kinematic and what is pair, kinematic pair. Distinguish and categorize different types of links. Link will categorize. Then know inversions of different kinematic chains, because inversions are providing way of solution. That's why it is called as inversion. Then understand utility of various mechanisms for force bar kinematic chain, where that kinematic chains are used and what different mechanisms are formed from that. That we are going to understand after completion of this unit. Okay. Now this is what the introductory part actually unit we are going to start, and that will start tomorrow. Here we'll stop. Before stopping, let me know that do you have any question? Any one of you? Don't leave this meeting, because I have to take presenting, and later on you can leave the meeting. Any question?
No, sir.
No, Ajit has said no. Gorakh? Kapre?
No, sir.
No, okay. Suhas, are you there, Suhas?
No, sir. Hello. No question. No question.
Sir. Okay, no problem. So I'll stop here.